Hi, my name is Jonas. Recently, I did a video about the Pultec EQ and the so-called low-end trick. For such a specific subject, it did quite well and I got a lot of comments. One of the returning questions was to also make a video about the UREI 1176, probably the most famous compressor of all times. I remember using it long ago when I was training for an audio engineer in a barn that was turned into a studio somewhere in Holland, and we spent hours and hours on the UREI 1176 trying to fine-tune a snare. Good times. So let's talk about this famous solid-state peak limiter and the way it got used and abused by many, many audio engineers. In 1967, Bill Putnam of United Recordings Electronic Industries, in short UREI, came up with a new design for a compressor using field effect transistors, FETs. These were newly invented technology at the time and could be used to replace vacuum tubes. This design process resulted in the 1176. It uses soft knee compression and a fixed threshold. This means you can't control the threshold directly, but by selecting a different ratio, the threshold will change as well. To control the amount of compression, you can use the input control knob, and to select a character, there's an attack and release control. There are four different compression ratios: 4:1, 8:1, 12:1, and 20:1. This is a mono device, so to process a stereo signal, two units had to be linked. So what makes the 1176 special is that the release time is program dependent. This means it can be shorter or longer depending on the signal. A snare with a transient, for example, will cause the release to be faster, while after a sustained signal, it will slow down. This will reduce the so-called pumping effect. This means when using the right settings, vocals, drums, basses can be compressed quite a lot while still sounding natural. It has been said the 1176 also changes the character of the sound slightly, making things brighter. And then there is the old mode, also called the British mode. The story goes that British engineers discovered it was possible to push in all ratio buttons at once. The resulting effect is that the ratio goes somewhere in between 4:1 and 20:1, and it causes the attack and release curves to change dramatically. It introduces a lot of interesting harmonic distortion. Once again, an example, just like with a Pultec, where using a device in an unexpected way is the base of a famous audio engineering trick. Let's check out what the 1176 is all about. I don't have an original unit at hand, they're quite pricey, and I actually really considered getting one of the hardware clones, especially for the video, but in the end I opted to not do this. Nowadays, when I need an 1176 in my own productions, I always use one of the plugins. There are quite a few very good ones that sound really close to the original, at least close enough for me. So today we're going to demonstrate the capabilities of the 1176 with the Arturia version, which is called the FET76. One of the cool features of the FET76 is that it actually has the all mode included as an option as well. So we can actually listen to the effect of this so-called all mode or British mode. First, we're going to compress a vocal. I'm going to play it bypassed, and then I'm going to loop it and up the ratio every loop until we're in all mode. For compressing this vocal, I will use a relatively slow attack time and a medium release, but keep in mind the release is program dependent, which means if there are transients, the release will go a little bit faster. If there are longer sustained sounds, then the release will get a little bit slower. It's one of the main characteristics of the 1176.
Searching for truth in this twisted environment, I can't believe that I once was inspired by you. I'll be okay. Searching for truth in this twisted environment, I can't believe that I once was inspired by you. I'll be okay. Searching for truth in this twisted environment, I can't believe that I once was inspired by you. I'll be okay. Searching for truth in this twisted environment. I can't believe that I once was inspired by you. I'll be okay. Searching for truth in this twisted environment. I can't believe that I once was inspired by you. I'll be okay. Searching for truth in this twisted environment. I can't believe that I once was inspired by you. I'll be okay.
As you could hear with that slow attack time, that first S gets through completely, so maybe you want to process that a little bit differently. But afterwards, you can clearly hear what is the difference of all the ratios and what effect they have on the attack and release times. And of course, the old mode introduces a lot of interesting harmonic distortion, which could be a very nice specific sound you're looking for. Next, let's put some drums through the 1176. In this case, I'm going to use a very fast attack. One of the things that the 1176 is famous for, actually, the very fast snappy attack. And the release will also be quite fast. So let's check it out. First bypassed, and then I'm going to up the ratios until we're in all mode again. You can hear that, especially in the higher ratios, you can alter the sound quite dramatically. I think the 20:1 mode is pretty nice to have this really punchy sound, but also the old mode is quite nice, especially if you would use this for parallel compression, which is actually quite easy to do with the Arturia plugin, because you can mix the dry and the compressed signal on the unit itself. So maybe let's quickly listen to how that would sound. And because this is my channel, I'm obviously also going to try this on some electronic beats. I programmed a drum loop on the Roland TR-8S, and I'm going to try some pretty aggressive settings. First, I'm going to play it bypassed, and then I will show you how it sounds with the 20:1 ratio and then the all mode. So it's the same as with the acoustic drums. If you're going to use the L mode, it's very useful if you want to do some nice parallel compression. But also the 20:1 mode is very usable for some nice snappy drums. So with the right settings, the 1176 is great for vocals, subtle and a lot less subtle, certainly if you go to the L mode. And you can use it perfectly fine for acoustic drums, electronic drums, separate drums like snares, kicks. It's a very useful and musical compressor, and it's no surprise why it's already been used for more than 50 years. If you want to know about famous users, well, I think it's basically everybody. The 1176 has been used on records of the Rolling Stones, Led Zeppelin and Michael Jackson, just to name a few. There have been quite a few revisions over the years. Some of the notable ones are the Blue Stripe Revision A, or the Blackface Revision C, and since 2000 there's a reissue as well, as Universal Audio has been re-established by the sons of Bill Putnam. And because the original units are quite pricey, of course there are many, many clones. Examples are the WA76 by Warm Audio, the MC77 by Purple Audio, and many plugins like the ones by UAD, Waves, Arturia, Ikey Multimedia, and many, many more. Some of these even include the All Mode, like the Arturia one, for example. And that's it again for today. If you want more like this, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. And if you want to be notified as soon as a new video goes online, click the bell button. Bye bye.